Up to this point, we've learned how to write single chords for choir and keyboards. We've also seen the basics of how those chords can be composed out over time in richer instrumental textures. In this lesson, we'll begin to combine multiple, different chords. Those of you who have taken a course on music fundamentals will be familiar with Roman numeral notation, which indicates the scale step on which a chord is built. Consider the following C major scale, each note of which is assigned a number, called a scale degree. Triads built on these scale degrees are referred to by corresponding Roman numerals. In some traditions, the quality of a triad is indicated by case. Uppercase Roman numerals indicate major, and lowercase Roman numerals indicate minor. Additional symbols appended to these Roman numerals indicate augmented and diminished qualities. Uppercase Roman numerals with a plus sign indicate augmented, and lowercase Roman numerals with a circle indicate diminished. It's useful to think of chords within the tonal system as being attracted to one another, much like objects in the Newtonian universe. Let's flesh out this analogy with respect to three principal triads, 1, 4, and 5. The most stable chord in the tonal universe is the 1 chord, also referred to as the tonic. For this reason, we'll use it as our main point of reference. In order to construct a hierarchy of attraction, we need to know which chord has the strongest gravitational pull toward 1. Consider the following incomplete melody in C major. What does your intuition tell you about the missing note? Chances are your brain will anticipate something like this. Many of you will have experienced the B natural in measure 6, the 7th scale degree, as being imbued with some kind of power, a force that leads our ear inevitably to the ensuing C. This salient gravitational quality has led musicians to call this scale degree by a special name, the leading tone, or in French, la sensible, the sensitive note, or in German, Leitton, guide tone. This note accounts partially for the 5 chord's strong gravitational pull toward 1, an especially tense relationship, for which we refer to 5 as the dominant. The leading tone, however, doesn't tell the whole story. Root motion also plays an important role in musical direction. In general, chords whose roots are separated by a fifth, like 5 and 1, tend to produce an especially strong sense of direction. Owing to these powerful forces, much of tonal music is predicated on the stark opposition between tonic and dominant chords. So what about 4? How does it fit into our gravitational model of harmony? Like 5, the 4 chord shares a single note with the 1 chord, but it doesn't contain the forceful leading tone. This alone renders its gravitational pull toward the tonic weaker. Taken together, 1, 4, and 5 can be represented in the tonal system in the following way, where dotted arrows represent common tones, solid arrows represent the leading tone, and distance represents an approximation of gravitational pull between chords. In addition to clarifying the relative strength of the tonic-dominant relationship, this diagram also gives us insight into how chords progress from one to the next. Owing to the grounded nature of the 1 chord, the most stable harmonic progressions begin with the tonic. And owing to the tonic dominant forces described earlier, 5 chords typically move directly to 1 chords. This information leads us to the basic harmonic syntax, that is the functional ordering of chords, of this repertoire. 1, 4, 5, 1. Note that any chord within this sequence can be skipped over, as long as the order is preserved. Put another way, in the classical style at least, five chords typically don't move directly to four chords. Here are some examples of progressions that follow this basic syntax. Notice how the first progression, with its lack of leading tone motion, feels less directed than the others. This doesn't mean it's defective in any way, but composers should be aware of this qualitative difference and use it accordingly. Once you know how to create a sense of tonal direction, you may also want to be more ambiguous at times, but this should be done consciously with a definite intent. When it's done by accident, it just weakens the overall effect, making the music sound less convincing. We'll end this lesson with an example by Mozart, the coda of his famous Rondo alla Turca, to illustrate how three simple chords can form the basis of an extended musical passage. As you listen, notice how Mozart begins each individual phrase with a 1-4-1 progression, saving the more directed 5-1 for the end. Ultimately, tonality is about creating a feeling of direction and manipulating that feeling to various musical ends. There's nothing written in the stars about how chords should progress from one to the next, but stylistic norms acquired through repeated exposure are very powerful in that they create expectations in the listener, like the leading tone resolving to the tonic, that a composer can then play with. Music that creates few or no expectations tends to fall flat.